So, you want an instant health check on your YouTube channel. You want to know how it's performing over the last month. What are your best videos? Where can you optimize your metadata? And how you can take actions immediately to improve your content? Let's call it channel audits, and let's do this right now.
vidIQ.
vidIQ.
vidIQ.com.
Hello folks, welcome back to vidIQ. My name is Rob. If this is your first time here, we are the YouTube tool and YouTube channel that aims to help you get more views in less time, grow your own channel, and make an impact with your audience. And today's video is all about a brand new vidIQ tool. If you haven't already downloaded the Chrome extension, a link is in the description. It is free to download, and this tool is going to revolutionize the way you review your channel. It is called Channel Audits, and you will find it on the left-hand side YouTube navigation bar below some of our pre-existing tools, and when you click on it, it's going to look a little like this. Before we jump into the devil of these details, a couple of ground rules. This tool always audits your own channel. It doesn't audit another channel if you're watching their video, so you can be safe in the knowledge that this private data remains your data. On the tool itself, you can mouse over some of the analytics to give you more information. For example, if I mouse over subscribers gained, it will show me the subscriber growth last month versus this month as a comparison. You have little information icons here. These are tooltips which you can mouse over for more information. And all of these panels are clickable in some fashion. For example, if I click on subscribers here, this will link me to the subscribers gained from all of my videos on YouTube. So this is going into YouTube Analytics. Some of the clickable cards will take us to screens where it will require a pro upgrade. So if I go to end screens at the bottom here, it will show me the first couple as a free user and then more information for pro users, and we'll get onto that in a little more detail later on. The channel audit tool then, it's 17 metrics broken up into four different sections. Starting at the top, we have the channel snapshot, showing you a comparison of your views, subscribers, and watch time over the last month. As we can see here, we have some issues with views and watch time down. Maybe that's because we produce less videos or less people are watching our content, but those that do are subscribing to our content on a more regular basis. As we've said already, you can mouse over each of these metrics to get the specific comparison for each and click on these panels. For example, if I click on views, this will show us a comparison graph via the YouTube Analytics for views for last month and the previous month. So you can get a clear indication there of what's happening on our channel. So we're merging vidIQ tools here with YouTube Analytics. Now we get onto a really exciting section of the channel audit tool, and that is content to double down on. Whether you made the video 3 weeks ago or 3 months ago, this section will tell you what videos on your channel are performing well right now and what you should perhaps follow up on with more content. It's done by video velocity, what videos are trending right now, views per hour. Also, total watch time, a really imperative metric on YouTube for promoting your content via impressions and click-through rates, which we've done videos on in the past. And also, subscribers gained from videos. So what these metrics are telling us here from the channel audit is that we have certain videos that perform well in terms of minutes watched, but we have other videos that perform well in building an audience over a longer period of time. For example, on subscribers, where we've gained 164 subscribers from how to get 1,000 subscribers on YouTube, that influenced me directly to produce a new video, which is how to get 100 subscribers on YouTube. So this is a really interesting tool to find out maybe other videos you produced a long time ago and have kind of forgotten about, just how valuable they are to your community. Now, as we said earlier, the data doesn't stop here. Each of these sections is clickable. If I click on views per hour, that would take me to the real-time analytics on YouTube. If I click total watch time, that will list all the videos in order of watch time. We see three from the channel audit tool, but we can see all of them from the YouTube analytics here. And as we've seen earlier, we can do the same thing with subscribers, find out which videos are gaining the most subscribers. The channel audit shows 3, but it links through to YouTube analytics where it shows you of the entire list over the last 30 days. And finally, this section here, top search terms, shows you where views are coming from for searches. Obviously we rank well for vidIQ, but it's interesting to note here that we do well on sub for sub, and on monetization topics such as 4,000 hours of watch time, 1,000 subscribers. If I click on any of these, it will show me where the audience is coming from for each of these search terms, as we can see down here. So plenty more to look at beyond the channel audit tool itself. So far, what we've shown you is YouTube data that can help steer you in the right direction with future content. But what about your content that's already out there on YouTube? Is there any way we can optimize it instantly? And this is where we come to the next two sections, average metrics over the last 30 days and items to improve on. The first section is all about optimizing your metadata, titles, descriptions, tags, playlists, and search engine optimization. It's all done through averages. So if we look at the first panel here, this is the average title length for the videos we've made over the last 30 days, and it comes in at 53, which is a good target. You can mouse over the information icon to give you a more thorough breakdown of what we think are the optimal sizes for titles and descriptions. And we say the maximum length should be around about 60, because once you get beyond 60, it cuts off the title on previews and gets a little wordy. Now here's the magic trick. If you tap on the title length panel, it shows you a breakdown of all the titles you've made for videos over the last 30 days. And as you can see, while we're doing pretty well, there are some that are not quite perfect here. We've got one which has 72 characters, that may be a little long, and another one here which is just a fraction over the title length. Now what makes this tool really powerful is if we click on the edit button here, that takes us directly to the video info page where we can adjust that title if we want to. How cool is that? Now if you're a vidIQ basic free user, this is a screen you will see when you look at actionable items. You will see 2 videos from the total list. Pro and Boost users gain full access to the entire channel audit tool. And one navigation point here, if you want to go back to the channel audit page, then click the go back button in the top left hand corner here. You can use the channel audit tool as a hub for actionable items. Take this as an example. If I click on actionable SEO score, we've mostly done a good job, but there's 2 videos at the top here which definitely require attention in terms of tags, titles, and descriptions. If we look at end screens, this is YouTube blasphemy. I forgot to put end screens on some of my videos. I need to fix that immediately. There's no excuse for not directing your audience to more of your content at the end of videos. And finally here, videos not added to playlists. Again, you should be adding all of your videos to some playlist. Why haven't I done this for these videos? This tool allows me to fix that almost instantly. The final section here, posting schedule, if you click on this, it does a funky little YouTube analytic where it overlays watch time with videos published, so you can see how the publishing of videos affects your watch time. And this can all be done from the channel audit tool. All right, stop what you're doing, click on that channel audit button right now, let it do its thing, and then let us know in the comments below where it thinks you need to improve most. That could be shorter titles, longer descriptions, more tags, videos in playlists. When you use the channel audit tool, you're gonna have a, oh my God, how did I even live without this tool moment. It tells you everything you were doing wrong in 20 seconds while you've been fumbling around in the dark for months. And of course, use the top section to help find out where you're doing things right and create more content. Now we think the channel audit tool is the start of something enormous. This is version 1. And we want to improve it with later versions. So if you want to have your input in what should be on next with the channel audit tool, let us know in the comments below. We've also gone even more granular with audits recently. The video optimization checklist tool shows you 15 different metrics where you can improve at specific videos. There's a tutorial right there now, and there's also another tutorial on another amazing vidIQ tool down here as well. Enjoy the rest of your video making day, and we'll see you all again soon. Bye for now.